Thank you so much, everyone, for inviting me along to speak to you today about some of the work we're doing at the library. I'm coming to you from Dharawal country, so I'd like to pay my respects to elders past, present, and emerging, and thank them for their custodianship of the land that I get to call home. I've been working from home for about 2 years now, as everybody else has, and if you do hear any weird sounds in the background, it's just my dog snoring on the floor down there, so I have to kind of make an apology for them every time I present these days, so which is a bit weird. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about our Tiger project. So just to give you some context, you may have seen that the library released a new catalogue earlier on in the year. So we actually rebuilt a brand new library catalogue from the ground up. It's been a very significant software development project that we've been working on for several years. And one of the features of the new catalogue is a digital collections portal. So the DC portal is essentially a subset of the library's full archive where users can more easily browse and discover open access digital material from the collection. So we have a very, very large collection. There's already around, well, there's over 5 million items already available in DC right now, and we're still adding more material to the site all the time. So we've got a very, very large very, very large archive, and it was very challenging previously to find or to find some of the digital collections in the full archive from the library. And one of the reasons for that is that we don't always create what we call file level metadata in our collections. So we don't describe individual files and images when we're through a traditional cataloging process every time. So in order to be able to make those lower level, more granular sort of levels of the collection more discoverable, we needed to find a way to create file level metadata. But because we are, you know, we're dealing with such a large collection, we needed to find a way that we could do that at scale, as you know, cost effectively as possible and as quickly as possible as well. So that inevitably led us to exploring, you know, the use of machine learning and AI services. So Tiger is effectively the library's automated image tagging project. Tiger stands for tagging images generically for exploration and research. The reason why Tiger is a little different to other sort of image tagging projects out there and other examples that you may have seen is that we actually tag all of the images from the library's collection with three different commercial off-the-shelf services. So we tag everything with Google, Microsoft, and Amazon. And the Tiger component is actually our custom algorithm that sits over the top of that, that is effectively like our built-in QA system or process. So the idea is that the Tiger component analyzes all of the raw data that we get from the three different services and tries to identify the most relevant and the most accurate terms from the raw data. And we only deliver the Tiger tags to the user and not the full raw list. So the algorithm is kind of a rules-based approach. It looks at things like confidence level ratings of different terms across the data that we receive from the three services. And we also take into consideration things like repetition and duplication of terms across the services. So because we're using three different services, we can compare and contrast them to each other. So just to break that down in a little bit more detail, so it's effectively the rules-based system is essentially like a series of mathematical equations that looks at all the different raw data that we get from those services. And we look at things like the confidence level rating. So the higher the confidence level, the more likely we will accept that term because higher confidence generally, not always, but generally equates to higher level of accuracy. And again, we will look at things like, you know, did two of the three services get the same tag? If so, we're more likely to weight that higher than a term that was only received by or delivered by one of the services. So one thing to note about the rules as well is this slide makes it feel very succinct and simple and straightforward, but this was months and months of work to get to this because we have such a large and such a varied collection. It was really challenging to come up with a series of rules that would work for the majority of the collection. So yes, it was quite a challenging process, and there was a lot of tweaking and changing and adding and subtracting rules to sort of get to this sweet spot. So just to show you what it looks like in practice, so this is an illustration of a rainbow lorikeet from our Derby collection. It has been tagged, as you can see, with animal, bird, and parrot. So these are the three tags that we deliver to the user that has gone through the Tiger process. So it would mean, for example, if someone was doing research around parrots, this particular image would come up in their search results. But if we look at the raw tags that were received from the three different services, so they're all of the tags that are marked here in green. So all of the green tags here have actually been removed as part of the Tiger process because they didn't meet our various rules from the custom algorithm. So the idea with Tiger is it's trying to remove as much of that white noise as possible when it comes to all of the different tags that we receive from the three services. So another example, so this is an image of Circular Quay, and there's obviously quite a lot going on in this image, but one of the key themes is that there are cable cars or trams in the image. So you can see that the tiger tags that we've delivered are cable car, transportation, and vehicle. But if we look at the longer list of tags that were eliminated, you can see that there's quite a lot of other terms here, many of which have no relevance to this image, and we're getting all the way down to less than 5% level of accuracy in the confidence of those terms. So really getting into the weeds, and Tiger was able to eliminate those terms. And as well as being able to remove as much of that white noise as possible, one of the really key parts of this project is that it was about doing this process, doing this QA process with as little or basically no human intervention at all. So the idea was we needed to build a system that where we didn't require staff to be, we had more confidence where we didn't require staff to review the data that we were making available to the user. So that's why we've been, quite strict with the rules that we've applied so that we are removing as much of that white noise as we possibly can. So as well as creating more data about at the file level, so more of that file level metadata, which is what we had set out to do, one of the really interesting things that Tiger has been able to deliver to us is other ways or lenses of viewing the collection that weren't really possible before. So I'm just going to show you a few examples. So this is one that I really enjoy. So this is the tag of triangle, and you can see here that each of the images that have been tagged with triangle is because they have very distinct triangular shapes in the frames of the images. So even if these are all images that we did create our own file level metadata for, through a traditional cataloging process, triangle is not the kind of tag that we would have applied to these images because it's not relevant to the context or the content within the images or the collections themselves. So this has really created a really interesting and quite a unique way of exploring the collection that we would never have been able to make possible before. And another example of that is this tag, for example, of a flightless bird. So each of the individual images here in this set, they would have been tagged with things like penguin and emu and cassowary, but never before could we have had a common theme or a way to start browsing those collections together. So they have been brought together with the term of flightless bird, and it means that we can start bringing sort of those disparate collections together for the first time, which is really interesting. Again, this is another example I really like. So this is just a very simple tag of the word sign. You can see that we're seeing things like road signs and street signs and protest signs. But what is really interesting here is we're also seeing archival material alongside contemporary material. And it's not impossible to, to search the collection with this kind of lens, but we've made it a lot easier to do that with, with the work that we've done with Tiger as well, which has been really interesting. So while we've sort of, at this point in the project, which was probably around about, we launched back in, I think it was the beta version was back last year, maybe in June last year. So it's been over a year. So when we got to that original point, we could basically say, yes, we checked the box of what we set out, the original aim of what we set out to do, which is to create more file level metadata and to make those more granular parts of the collection more easily discoverable. But one of the things we didn't do with this project, and maybe one of the things we potentially made a little bit worse or harder for users, was that we didn't make it easier for users to understand what the library actually had in the collection. And that's something that that's a feedback that we get all the time, is that because the collection is so huge, people just don't really know how to penetrate it, and they don't understand what is in the library's collection because we have such a varied collection as well. It makes it quite challenging to be really familiar with, what we hold in the collection. And so this Tiger process hasn't really resolved that in any way. So if we look at, for example, this search here, so I've done the search for violin, and I'm seeing a series of results of images of people playing violin. So that's exactly what I would expect to see in this kind of search, for what I've searched for. But what I didn't know to search for was anything that might have been related to this term, and I would have had no understanding of what else the library might hold that would be related to my search of violin. So if you have a look on the right-hand side there, you can see that there's a list of terms, and these are all the related tags that had been identified as related to my search of violin. So there's quite a few terms here that are relevant to what I've been looking for. So musical instrument, stringed instrument, fiddle, violinist, violin family. So lots of other terms that might be related, but I didn't know to look for them, or I didn't know that they existed. So what I've had to do is start at that really granular file level, and then as the user, if I was interested, broaden my search and go out further to see some of the other related terms within the collection. So what I really wanted to explore was, could we invert that process and actually allow users to start more broad by starting at the real high level and then drilling down to, you know, to get more specific with their searching as they got a better understanding of what we actually held in the collection. And one of the challenges, well, we basically couldn't do that before with the original data that we had created through Tiger, because what we had essentially done was just create a big bucket of thousands and thousands of tags from all the different millions of images that we had tagged. But there was just, yeah, it was just a big bucket. There was no hierarchy, no structure. There was no relational information. You know, it was just another sort of impenetrable data set that we had created. So in order to try and bring some structure and to bring like and, you know, group terms together, we decided we wanted to explore the opportunity for creating a hierarchy with this data. So to do that, we decided to work with a pre-existing data set. So we worked with the Library of Congress Thesaurus for Graphic Materials, which is a very common cataloging standard that's used all around the world, and we already use it at the library anyway. So we thought, okay, well, can we use this pre-existing taxonomy thesaurus, you know, hierarchical thesaurus, as our foundation to try and replicate this as much as possible with the tags that we had created through Tiger? So what we did first was a one-to-one matching process. So we actually just tried to see, using the Locke thesaurus as the foundation, how many of these terms could we replicate? And in doing so, just with this particular snippet under musical instruments here, we were actually able to get a matches to about two-thirds of the terms, which is actually, you know, a pretty good result. That's probably more than what I was expecting. So there were some terms here that didn't have any matches. So for example, ukulele, we didn't have any images with the tag of ukulele. So what we were able to do, though, even like if we remove those terms that that had no matches, we've still been able to create, you know, a fairly good hierarchical structure with the terms. And suddenly we've got some relational information here and some grouping that would allow a user to, for example, start looking at musical instruments, see everything that we had tagged with musical instruments, but also see, you know, the children and grandchildren and the kind of like the hierarchical structure of the terms and see what else we had related to that area of interest for them. So we're really, really pleased with this result. And I was quite happy with the amount of matches that we got, because I was expecting it to be a lot less than what we did get. But there were still lots of terms that didn't get matched because they didn't have that sort of identical one-to-one matching. So the secondary process that we went through was using natural language processing techniques such as lemming and stemming to try and bring in those secondary terms with things like, you know, matching things like synonyms and sort of inflections and different pluralized words to try and bring more of those orphan terms into the structure. So by doing a bit of experimenting in this space, we're actually able to bring in quite a lot of additional terms. So everything that's marked here in orange are the new terms that we got to bring in through that process. So we've effectively been able to double the hierarchy structure and made it more easy for users to be able to browse this data at the top level and then drill down. So the last 6 months or so, we've been working, you know, quite hard from a data point of view. So building out this data in a structure in the new library's collections API. That's the API that actually powers the new catalog. So we've got all the data ready to go. And now what we're actually currently in development is building an interface where users will actually be able to access and browse this data. So the next few screens I'm showing you are just the design mockups, but these are what are currently in development and what we'll have available, you know, hopefully pretty soon. So what we'll be doing is building what we're calling a tag index. So it's essentially will just be an alphabetized index where users can browse all of the different terms, the Tiger terms, you know, alphabetically, and they'll be able to get some of the better understanding of the structure that we have, that we've been able to create with these new hierarchies that we've put together. So it'll also have a bit of a predictive search. So you'll be able to type in a term and see, you know, all the different terms that we have related to the letters that you've typed into the search bar there. And then once you actually select an individual tag page, so this in this instance for locomotive, we'll actually be able to show you our results set. So where locomotive sits in that hierarchical structure. So what are its siblings, who are its parents, its grandparents and great grandparents, etc. So you'll actually be able to sort of see it in context of the hierarchy that we have created. And then you'll also be able to see some samples of the images that have been tagged with locomotive. And then, of course, you can click through and get a search results page to see everything that's been tagged with that keyword as well. So it's basically creating just another way of accessing the same data. We haven't added any additional data. We haven't created any new tags with this process, but what we've been able to do is just create a different level of structure, which provides a different way into the material and into the data, and hopefully allowing users to get that better and more comprehensive understanding of what we hold in the collection. So this is where we're at the moment. We've still got quite a lot of work to do. It's a very iterative project. We'll be looking at things like training our own custom algorithms rather than using those commercial services. Really, really keen on building in a process for things like user-generated feedback and user-generated tags. So because we don't have any human intervention in the tagging process, if we can have a mechanism where we can get feedback from our researchers and users, that will be really beneficial for us. And then, of course, because this technology is ever changing, we've also got the opportunity of exploring using different, you know, improved technologies and improved services. And we may even go through the process of re-tagging our images, you know, further down the track to see if we can get more accurate results as well. So really, really hoping we'll have that tag index probably. We were trying to get it done by the end of the year, but that's getting pretty close. So it might be more likely January. But, you know, watch this space because, you know, the index is going to go live, you know, hopefully in the next couple of months. And we're really, really keen to get feedback and see if it actually does, you know, improve users' opportunity and ability to understand what the library has in the collection and get more specific with their searching as well. So that's it from me. Thank you so much. And I'll just stop sharing.